A new world calls across the ocean.
A new world calls across the sky. A new world whispers in the shadows. Time to fly. Time to fly.
About one moment, that moment before it all becomes clear.
And in that one moment, you start to believe there's nothing to fear.
It's about 1 second, and just when you're on the verge of success, the sky starts to change,
and the wind starts to blow.
And you didn't know that you sometimes have to go around an unexpected bend, and the road will end in a new
about one moment, the moment you think you know where you stand.
But in that one moment, the things that you're sure of slip from your hand.
But you got 1 second to try to be clear, to try to stand tall, that nothing's the same. And the wind starts to
find a lover you're sure you believe in.
You get a pool in the
bath. You get a part of your life.
But then the earthquake hits.
Then the bank closes in.
Then you realize you didn't know anything.
Nobody told you the best way to steer when the wind starts to blow.
As a girl, I had a favorite story.
the meadowlark who lived where the rivers wind. Her voice could match the angels in its glory, but she was blind. The lark was blind. An old king came and took her to his palace, where the walls were burnished bronze and golden braid. And he fed her fruits and nuts from an ivory chalice. And he prayed, "Sing for me, my meadowlark. Sing for me,
sing for me
of the silver morning.
Set me free,
my meadowlark, and I'll buy you a priceless jewel, and cloth of brocade and crewel, and I'll love you for life if you will sing for me." But the meadowlark said no, for the old king loved her so. She couldn't bear to wound his pride, so the sun god flew away. And when the king came down that day, he found his meadowlark had died. Every time I heard that part, I cried. Fly away, meadowlark, fly away,
fly away
on the silver morning. Curse the dark. So it's off where the chains won't bind me. I know I leave wounds behind me, but I won't let tomorrow find me back this way. Before my past once again can blind me, fly away.
To know for sure
what
to fix the algorithm, like you said, to interpret the data better.
Sorry, I thought that we agreed that this was a ruse upon which we mutually conspired to get each other into bed.
Well, right, but you also said that given some more time.
Yeah. No, I may have said that, but in the spirit of post-coital honesty, I could try. But by the time it would be done running, both of us would be dead, and so would our children. So. The children we might someday have. With anybody, not necessarily with each other. What I'm trying to say is that I think that this is actually an example of non-deterministic polynomial time problems, which are all reducible to or derivable from one another because they're what we call NP-complete. And what this means is that if you solve any one of them, you'll actually have solved
them all. Have you done this before?
What?
This little presentation.
Well, yeah, of course, in class.
No, I mean, have you done this before in more or less this context? I knew it! This is your A material.
No!
No, it totally is. You say this to all the girls.
What? I talk about computational intractability.
I bet you do.
Oh, that gets everybody right into the sack.
Oh, I bet it does. I bet they're like non-deterministic polynomial time problems. Elliot, tell me more.
Look at it this way. Would you rather be unworthy of my A material?
Oh, I don't know. What does that look like?
That's where, as soon as we're finished, I just go, "So, how are you getting home?"
Yeah, shut the fuck up.
I can walk you as far as the door.
And they say chivalry is dead.
Oh my god, I was totally kidding. Please stay.
I know, I just have to pee again. I don't know what's wrong with me.
Maybe you're pregnant.
That's not funny.
It was a joke.
I know, but the joke's not funny.
Right, but keep in mind we had sex like an
Explaining
hour ago.
Explaining it more does not help.
Right, but the joke—
Elliot, no woman anywhere. Ever, since long before records of such things were kept, has ever found that joke funny.
Okay.
Okay. I feel like I tricked you into thinking that I'm any fun to be around.
Oh. Except I am having fun. You aren't leaving, right? You're gonna stay?
Yeah. I'm gonna stay. Am I nice?
No.
Thank you! Nobody thinks I'm a nice girl, okay? I'm the mistake.
Ah, Robbie. Midwestern heart, Midwestern body.
I'm the one who messes things up.
I agree with you.
I feel like he doesn't even know me. Ugh.
You're getting your smell all over the comforter.
Oh my God.
It took me months to get rid of that heavenly smell.
What happens when he realizes he was wrong about me the entire time? He's just gonna run away.
Hey, I would never run away from you. But if I did, I would run way faster than Robbie, because he's slow and I'm fast.
Maybe I'm just not meant for a functional relationship. You know me.
You don't ever have to be nice around me. I'm not scared of you.
I mean, I'm bad. I do bad things.
I don't think you're a nice girl at all. You're the worst.
No.
No?
No, I can't do this to Robbie.
Wait, but you're a bad person. We just discussed that. You're a bad person. I'm a bad person. We could totally do this. No qualms.
I have a qualm.
Don't have a qualm.
I have a qualm.
We sold our qualms. We used the promise to buy perfect bodies.
Robbie is right.
What?
I'm nice.
But I'm not nice, all right? And I like Robbie, but that is doing nothing right now from stopping me from wanting to kiss you.
Stop.
I don't want to stop. I really don't. I never want to stop kissing you. I'm a monster.
I gotta go.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. I really needed this.
Uh-huh. So I'm a monster.
It's a bad idea, me and you.
I know. I totally agree.
It's a bad idea, me and you. I've never known anything so true. Yeah, it's a very poor idea, me and you. Heart, stop racing, let's face it. Making mistakes like this will make worse what was already pretty bad. Mind, stop running, it's time we just let this thing go. It was a pretty good bad idea, wasn't it though? See myself ever be anything more than what I've already become. I need a bad idea. I need a bad idea.
I need a bad idea. I need a bad idea.
Just one.
Heart, keep racing. Let's make mistakes. Let us say so what. Make worse what was already pretty bad. This secret is safe, no reason to throw it away. When there's love to be had, hold me tight as I tell myself that you might make sense and make good what has been just so bad. Let's see this through. It's a pretty good bad idea. Me and you.
Because I don't want to start.
Being stubborn.
Well, I'd rather be stubborn than be a literal child.
All I'm saying is that very few couples get their engagement photos taken at the Renaissance Fair, and it'd be very original of us
if we're not getting married.
Well, I'm not going to business school.
We both know that you don't want to spend eternity as a coffee barista when you could be running your own balloon animal company.
I told you that in confidence.
And I told you that a 10-year plan is very effective. For example, I go to college where I return for grad school, and I'm in a program to complete my dissertation on the Spice Girls comeback tour, where I will develop a serious case of baby fever and marry the first man with a fixed jawline who will take me, who is also shorter than me, and is a doctor. If you meet any of those requirements, any, then I suppose
okay,
we could maybe.
Okay, I get it.
Just come here. For one second, think about 36-year-old Tyler Evans.
Where is he?
Married to you.
Great. See you tomorrow.
Don't you feel the same way?
You're good company.
Good enough.
Your grandmother hates me.
Huh? Okay, she doesn't hate you.
And don't even get me started on Davis. Oh, yeah. No, I know how this works. I marry you, I marry him. And I'm not marrying him. The boy flosses on a schedule. Who flosses regularly?
Okay, you're being paranoid.
Oh, don't give me that. I wasn't born yesterday. I've seen Steve Harvey.
What is that? Okay, look. Look, Davis, he's a big boy. He can take care of himself.
Tyler, I need you!
What is it, Davey?
I just had the world's most catastrophically awful day. Get out, P.S. I love you. We're ordering Domino's and getting emotionally fucked up tonight. Oh, Chelsea, I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was interrupting. You're having childhood time. I really don't want to talk about it anyway.
Well, thank you, Davis.
Okay, but like, I'm sitting at my desk waiting for Patrick Greenbaum to finish his lunch so I can finally go on my break.
Patrick Greenbaum.
Yeah, I know. Here we go. He left the empty cup from his 15th green smoothie of the day next to my computer. So I toss it in the trash. He finally comes back from his break, notices the smoothie cup is gone, and actually accuses me of drinking it. So I'm like, no, Patrick, as hard as it is for you to believe, I did not drink your earth crunchy smoothie full of leaves and shit. And then he comes in his boat shoes.
Fucking
boat shoes. And he actually says, I bet you got tired of your Burger King fries and wanted something healthy.
Oh, and that's ridiculous, right? Because who would eat Burger King fries?
Well, hopefully everyone. Everyone. Anyway, then just as I'm starting
to spot. All
right,
no, we're not getting married.
Just hold on.
No. I am always holding on because it is always dialer time. Yeah.
Oh my God, honey. No. Of course not. It's called Tavis time. Dialer time would just be weird. Absolutely not. You can't marry her. You marry her. I marry her. I'm not marrying her. I've seen Steve Harvey.
What is that? Okay, look, we were together for 3 years now. What did you think was gonna happen?
That the spark in your relationship would fizzle. She cheated on you with a Norwegian model and then
Clark!
Oh, hey, yes. Do not bring Clark into this.
What did I do when you were too shy to ask him on a date?
You asked him on a date.
You had 3 happy months together before the toenail thing. Look, I have been ride or die Davis from day one. Why can't you do the same for me?
I can be supportive. Watch me. Chelsea! I think you should marry us.
What's about to happen?
I'm not gonna lie to you. You marry him, you marry me, but I'm not so bad I can tie a bow tie. It's like having a backup husband.
A vice husband.
Very funny.
We're thinking of you.
I will see you tomorrow, love. Okay.
She winked at me. She winked at me. You see that? What does that mean?
She has a twitch.
But forget every man who I ever met, 'cause they all only live to control. For a kiss they paid 1,000 yet, they paid 50 cents for my soul. They took their peace, the prize of fame that no one can repay. But they didn't buy me when they bought my name, and that is why I pray that when you see someone's hurt and in need of a hand, don't forget me. Or hear Melody crying for some baby grand. Don't forget me. When you sing happy birthday to someone you love, or see diamonds you wish were all free, please say that you won't. I pray that you don't forget me. There are some in this world who have strength of their own, never broken or in need of repair. But there are some born to shine who can't do it alone, so protect them and take special care. Take care and don't forget me. Please take care and don't forget me. When you look to the heavens with someone you love and a light shining bright from above,
You know, why don't they ever make a movie about what happens after the big kiss?
They do. It's called porn.
God, I miss sex. Right? I mean, sometimes you just need it. It's like, I don't know, it's like cracking your neck.
Why does it always gotta come with complications?
And emotions.
And guilt.
Ugh, guilt.
It's women's fault.
What?
You heard me. Hold me. Let's spend the rest of our lives together.
Oh, please, you are no better. Oh, yeah, baby! Come on now! Say my name! Oh, yeah! Oh, I'm done. How was I?
Who have you been with? Why can't it not be like that? It's a physical act, like playing tennis. Two people should be able to have sex like they're playing tennis.
Yeah, I mean, no one wants to go away for the weekend after they play tennis.
It's just a game. You shake hands, get on with your shit.
Do you want more beer?
Sure. Jamie, let's play tennis.
What?
Let's have sex like we're playing tennis.
Get the hell out of here!
Don't laugh. This could be great. This could take all the weirdness out of it.
Well, we talked about this. I don't like you like that.
I don't like you like that either. That's why it's perfect.
I don't even know if I find you attractive.
That's cute.
Well, I do have a thing for jerks. Okay, do you even find me attractive?
That's cute.
No, before you got to know my awesome personality, strictly physical, first time you saw me.
This is just two people talking.
Yeah, two girls over drinks at Bennigan's. Go.
I liked your eyes. I didn't think I'd ever seen such big, beautiful eyes.
Your lips. Yeah, I thought you might be a good kisser.
I am. Your breasts.
What about them?
They intrigued me.
Really?
Yeah.
I think they're so tiny.
They're still breasts.
Thanks. I liked your hands.
Mouth.
Butt.
Voice.
Chest.
Eyes.
You said that.
I meant it.
You swear you don't want anything more from me other than sex.
You swear you don't want anything more from me?
No relationship, no emotions, just sex.
Whatever happens, we stay friends.
Swear?
Swear.
Swear! All right, let's go to the bedroom.
What's wrong with the couch? It's less emotional.
The bedroom has better light, and since we're just friends, I don't have to be insecure about my body.
Come on, okay? You're beautiful. You have nothing to be insecure about.
No, you see, that is just way too emotionally supportive, and you need to just lock that down.
Your ass is a little bony.
Much better.
She shot me, she shot me, bang, bang, she shot me, she shot me, she shot me, bang, bang. Ah, there she goes again, the dopest Ethiopian. In other words, she came through, exploded in the podium. Dynamite, Napoleon, like sodium, mixed with petroleum. Slowly but surely, she was walking toward me. Cut the combo short, cause she had to wake up early. But continuing the story, don't worry, she gave me digits to her BlackBerry.
You're very handsome, is what she said. And the way she looked in my eyes said, put me to bed.
Oh my, I should have known when she said to me on the phone, you do not know me very well, but I would never hurt a fly.
And then she aimed at my chest with love in her eyes.
Said she aimed at my chest with love
well,
in her eyes.
She was walking around with a loaded shotgun,
ready to fight me a hot one.
It went bang, 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 straight through my heart. Although I could have walked away, I stood my ground and let her spray.
She shot me, bang, bang. She shot me, she shot me, she shot me, bang, bang.
Oh yeah, scorpion, she's so hot, she's a scorpion. Killing me softly, blowing or crook walking in. Couldn't tell if she's cuckoo or quirky when I asked her name. And she said, call me Ted. Testing, testing. Things just got more interesting. She's dressed in a vest pin, double-breasted holster, a very Western toaster. She ain't nothing kosher. Ah, she lets me close. Hotter than a pepper-crusted samosa. While I try to keep my
she was walking around with a loaded shotgun,
ready to fire me a hot one. It went bang, 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 straight through my heart.
Although I could have walked away, I stood my ground and let her spray. Ooh, she shot me, bang, bang, she shot me, she shot me, she shot me, bang, bang.
Ah!
What happened?
Tom Zoller happened. Here, I bought some stupid cookies. Girl Scouts, what a bunch of little bitches.
These are Samoas.
Damn right.
I wanted Thin Mints.
Fuck that.
Fuck you.
What's your problem?
Go home. I'm sick. You're annoying. I wanted Thin Mints.
What's wrong with you anyway?
Nothing. I just am tired. What happened with Zoller?
First I punched him in the face.
Why?
It's Tom Zoller, Doug. You don't go punching Tom Zoller in the face. What, do you have a death wish?
He threw me down and kicked me and wailed all over me, but I didn't care. I can take it. Fucking pussy.
Why did you pick a fight with him anyhow?
How come you weren't at school? Are you sick again?
I'm always sick.
You don't look sick.
I'm not. Not right at this minute, anyhow.
You sure look weird and you're all rude and everything.
Probably because I totally had sex today.
What?
With Tim.
Today? When? How? What are you talking about?
He's my boyfriend.
You're too young.
Oh, just because you've never had sex before.
I told you I had sex.
With your cousin.
We're not cousins, we're family friends. Shut up! I can't believe you had sex with Tim. That guy's nasty.
Okay, it's not like we've been doing it nonstop anyhow. We just had sex twice.
Twice?
Just forget it.
I can't just forget about it.
It wasn't,
What?
Nothing.
What?
Nothing! I did it. Twice. I got that over with.
Sounds like it was really fun.
It wasn't, okay? It wasn't fun. It was like Tim's over here and we have to pretend that everything is normal. And we're just playing around and wrestling around and then suddenly we're not. And suddenly, he's
like what?
Nothing.
I'm gonna kill him.
No, you're not.
Why's everybody gotta be so mean?
What?
Zoller called you a skank. You're not a skank, you're not. You're the prettiest girl I've ever seen.
I know.
When the money's gone, will you be my friend? Float a small rowboat till our ship comes in. When the winter nights chill us to the soul, will you feed the fire, spin the straw to gold? When the money's gone,
when the money's gone, will you get cold feet? Will you still be there if the ends don't meet? If we're in the red, just forget the green. Take a bus with me. No more limousines when the money's gone. Oh, what a fun life I'll give to you, all you ever want. Will you still be there? Will you pull me through when the cash don't come? And if you're mine, will you still love me whenever we fall?
Where have you been? We're starving.
Henry is starving. I am fed on the fruit of my companionship.
I hope you choke on the fruit of your companionship.
Like you choked on Burger Joint Boy's cheesy dick?
I have a question for you guys. Have you ever done something bad, like really, really bad that you definitely shouldn't have done, but you did it anyway and now it's done and it can never be undone?
A certain cheesy dick comes to mind.
Right, but what if this mistake can never ever be forgiven or forgotten, like absolutely life-altering?
Well, herpes stays with you forever.
Oh my God, Harmony, do you have herpes? That's awesome, we can synchronize our flare-ups.
I don't have herpes. Harmony, I'm sure whatever you did is not that bad. Nothing's that big of a deal.
All right, but could you hurry up and tell us we can order?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm sure you're right. I'm sure it's not that big of a deal. I'm definitely making a big deal out of nothing.
Right, so what is it?
Okay. How to put this? Knock, knock.
Who's there?
There's a dead body in my car.
There's a dead body in your car? Who?
My boss, Gary.
I'm sorry. Did you say there was a dead body in your car?
There's a cadaver in your Corolla. So what do you want to order?
Are you fucking insane? She just said there's a dead body in her car. How could you think about dinner right now?
Like you said, it's probably not a big deal.
No. I thought that was when she cut someone off in traffic or spilled coffee on her coworker, not killed her boss.
Oh, she never said she killed her boss.
I did kill my boss, yes.
Oh, well, that explains why you have a dead body in your car.
Oh my God, I have to call the cops.
And say what? My roommate has a dead body in her car?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm going to say.
They're not gonna believe you.
Why wouldn't they believe me? She has a dead body in her car.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
That's why I'm going to tell them what's not sinking in about this.
If we get rid of the body now, when the police come, they won't find anything.
No. I'm not on your side here. I'm very pro-police finding the dead body.
You're pro-police in this political climate?
Yeah, poor take, Robbie.
Well, of course you're anti-police, murderer!
I swear, it was almost an accident!
Almost.
Well, when I had my hands wrapped around his throat, I was only gonna apply enough pressure to knock him out. But then I realized I could just kill him.
Yeah. See, it was almost an accident.
The authorities should know that our roommate killed her boss.
Oh my God, we've been talking about this forever. Can we change topics?
No, please? We cannot change topics!
Fine. Do we have cleaning gloves and bleach in the bathroom?
Why?
To clean Harmony's car and get rid of the body without leaving fingerprints. What? Have you never disposed of a dead body before? Grow up.
Standing here all at once, all the words run dry.
Something changed, can't explain, and I can't deny.
Every word in every sentence doesn't seem to make a difference. Nothing can explain just what you mean to me.
Every shape and all the colors, all the love from all the lovers, never could express just what you mean to me.
Every instinct, every feeling,
every
breathless, all my senses reeling, cannot even say just what you mean to me.
Turning in circles and blurring the lines, I won't lie, I'm a little bit frightened of my imagination, swear I'll try. Inspiration. We can fly if we want to. I promise you, faith will give you wings.
Just take the second star on the right, straight ahead to the morning light. Let's take the second star on the right, straight ahead to the morning light. Every star that's ever fallen knows the way to where we're going. Now I really know just what you mean to me.
Welcome. This is where the magic happens, and as you well know, by magic, I mean nothing.
Do you want to go out with me?
What?
Well, I mean, do you want to be my girlfriend?
Brandon, just a couple of hours ago, you told me you were Kinsey 6 gay.
True. But you said I should pretend to be straight, so...
Yeah, it didn't mean with me. I mean, you're a nice guy and all, but you're not really my type.
Yeah, you're not really my type either.
Yeah, I know that. I got that V where you'd rather see a P.
Hey, do you want to have sex with me or not?
Oh my God, dude, no! That is not what I'm saying at all!
No, no, I know. What you were saying is that I should just pretend to be straight till I get out of this hellhole. Then I can be whoever I want to be. I get it. I do.
You know I didn't really have sex with a college guy, right? I just told everyone that I did.
So you're saying I shouldn't really have sex? I should just say I had sex with someone?
Yes.
A girl?
Yes. Oh, no.
No. What? No, please. Think about it.
Absolutely
we could help each other out.
No.
I'll pay you whatever you want.
I don't want your money, Brandon.
Look, it doesn't have to be a bonk. It could be anything. An imaginary butterbean, lemon squeeze, cowbell.
I don't know what any of that means.
That's because you're a virgin.
Okay. You know what? Fine. But I don't do anything half-assed, all right? You have to do everything I say and tell everyone that I am sensational.
Thank you for doing
this. Shut the drapes.
Hey, what are you doing?
Relax. Jeez, what is it with you gays? Are you really that repulsed by lady parts? What do you think I have down there? A gnome?
This is really pretty. What is it, lavender?
Can you come here, please? Come on. Now grunt. Make it convincing. No, I said grunt, not whine. Just grunt. Moan, you know? Like sex noises. God, you're pathetic.
Oh, you don't have to be so aggressive about it.
What, you like that? You like that?
No, I don't like that.
No, you don't like that? How about that?
Oh, a little better.
Yeah, you like that. Oh, yeah, don't stop.
I'm not gonna stop.
Now you try.
Oh, I'm gonna turn you around and take you from the back.
Yeah, that's not gonna make people think you're straight.
Take me as I am. This may mean you'll have to be a stronger man. Rest assured that when I start to make you nervous and I'm going to extremes, tomorrow I will change and today won't mean a thing. I'm a bitch.
I'm a lover.
I'm a child.
I'm a mother.
I'm a sinner.
I'm a saint.
I do not feel ashamed. I'm your hell.
I'm your dream. I'm nothing in between. You love
you.
Back there. You're a good friend.
I'm not your friend. I am not your friend. We are not hanging out.
I heard you yell to that guy. Did you take my friend?
Yeah, that's a saying. You never heard that saying before? Besides, friends don't steal friends' identities, do they? You're diabolical.
Oh, thanks.
That's not a compliment.
I know. Oh, here we go. Oh, come on.
You're doing great.
You're gonna have to hide on the next one. It's clearly you.
Oh, it's me.
I have never been passed up when I got this thing out.
I don't doubt that you do real well on the side of the road. But look, I don't know why you're not trusting this. Look, it says it's 2 miles straight through there.
2 miles through the woods?
Yeah. What, are you allergic to woods or something? Come on, you want to go 10 more miles on this road, get some more blisters? Come on, that's a shortcut. Yes? There's a yes, finally.
I knew you were probably wrong. I knew your phone was going to die. I should have said something.
You knew? What, are you like a psychic, huh?
You know what? I am! I'm not gonna get into it, but I am.
Really? On top of everything else, you're a psychic. That's amazing.
Pick a number between 1 and 10.
4.
4!
Thank God.
I know. It was a gift.
Oh, your gifts abound. That's amazing.
I think so, too.
Well, then why don't you just rest your talents then, Megamind? The sun's gonna be up in a few hours, and we'll take it the rest of the way. Hey, hey, spread out! You got the whole forest! What are you doing?
It's cold! This is what they do on Survivor!
When they want to get punched, get off me!
Do you usually listen to music before you go to bed?
No. Just a lot of silence.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like...
Diana, get your hands off. I don't want to play footsies.
This
is no longer our sleeping spot!
What you don't know is that I would do anything for you.
What you don't know is that I would do anything for you.
But you can think what you want.
There's only so much that I can do, and you don't see all that I am giving away.
And I'm asking for you to
Just you.
So I want to talk to you about our future.
Yes.
Can we get into it?
Yes.
All right, here, sit down for a second.
Okay.
Because in order to do that, I think we're going to have to get real.
Okay.
Now, I want to get very real with you right now.
Okay.
Can I do that? Because I feel like I'm always coddling you.
Interesting. Yeah,
but that's neither here nor there. I just want to be real with you for a second, okay? Yeah, so the acting thing. It's done. But it's been done for a while. I mean, it was old in 2006. It's way too old now. And you're bad at it.
Thank you. For your honesty.
Yeah, are you cool?
Oh, so much do I appreciate you for that.
Thank you.
Yeah,
okay, good.
That must have been hard for you to say.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Can I be honest with you?
Yeah, I need you to.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, so the veterinarian thing.
Yeah.
I feel like the only reason you want to be a vet was to keep the skins.
What?
You'll want to keep the skins,
don't you? No, I mean, there's no denying that the skins are fascinating. It's the most fascinating part of the animal. The skin of any animal is the most fascinating part.
Also, you're going bald.
What? I'm going bald. What are you talking
about? Yeah, I'm just trying to let you know.
Where the hell am I possibly going bald?
Yeah, in the back of your head.
There's no evidence of that. Oh, there's
plenty of evidence to grab two mirrors.
No, don't grab two mirrors because you're not going to find anything.
I see fat spilling over the back of your pants. What the hell are you talking about? I'm just trying to let you know.
No, and by the way, there's no reason why a bald man who loves skins, who's got a little bit of extra something around his belly, can't be a goddamn veterinarian.
All right, you know what? I cannot.
You are a wrinkled bitch! No. Stop. I don't want to do this with you, okay? Yeah. Do you see what's happening?
Yeah, we leapt right back in.
Yeah, into our old routines.
That same old place.
Yeah, and I don't want to do that with you, okay?
Okay.
Because let's just focus here.
Right.
Here's what we're going to do.
Okay.
We're going to polish off this wine.
Okay.
We're going to open up this new bottle of vino.
Ooh.
And let's talk about our real futures.
To new beginnings.
Got his way, he disappeared without a trace, and the girl is left alone under her sycamore tree, and teardrops fall. Breathe, child, breathe. And the wind cried, willow, 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 get your head up off the pillow, pillow, pillow. Dreamed a dream, or so it seems, the little girls had fantasies.
Look around, we are all the playthings of men in this town. Look around, what you'll find, what you'll see, is that men couldn't care less about your fantasy. Believe me, deceiving, conniving, contriving, the lights can be blinding. With flowers in their hand, but pockets full of dust, ain't no trust in a man.
I can change.
Bet on love, but you can't bet on love.
Way.
How can I erase these mistakes I've made?
I wanted to love and be loved. I wanted to love and be loved. I wanted to love and be loved. But instead I've come undone. I can be there for her.
This is my time.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing?
Urinating!
Bingo!
But you can't urinate here!
That's okay. I'm done.
Are you from around here?
No, thank God. I'm waiting forever for my stupid mother to get done giving to some book to some priest.
Why didn't you just go to the bathroom inside the house? Never mind. I came to talk to Father McNally. I'll come back later. I had a question for him, that's all.
No, if God exists, why does he let all those babies starve to death in Somalia? Is that your question?
No.
And how can people say things like, God was really watching over me because my car flipped over and caught on fire, and I got these bad burns, but I didn't die? If God was watching over them, how come their car flipped over and caught on fire in the first place? Is that your question?
No.
Things to think about, though, right?
You must get really good grades in school.
Wrong. I don't think you're the best judge of character. I don't get the feeling you get out much.
I look at pornography.
You don't look at ladies' titties, do you?
No.
Worse?
Yes.
Stuff about girls with big butts, maybe? You like that stuff? Worse than big butt pornography? Nothing is worse than big butt pornography!
No, there's worse.
Like what?
Stuff about guys, sometimes.
Oh, okay.
This is what I came to talk to Father McNally about. You know, whether it's okay.
You wanted to ask a priest whether it was okay for you to be looking at gay guys having sex. That was your big plan for coming here?
Well, I know it's not okay, great. But you know, whether it made me a fag in the eyes of the Lord.
It probably doesn't exactly make you straight.
I don't want to be gay. I want to meet a nice wife someday.
Okay, then repent. Put your underwear on your head, say 11 Hail Marys.
Does your family, like, go to church or anything?
My mom doesn't believe in church.
You can kind of tell. Lots of people believe in God.
Do you?
Well, I definitely don't not believe in God.
Okay, here you go then. Holy moly, you are healed from being gay as a pineapple upside down cake.
Stop that.
Take 5 shots. Take off all your clothes. Put your underwear on your head. Say 10 Hail Marys. Go on. I mean it. Do it.
Never thought that I could ride so high without you. Everything I've got so good, but not without you. Suddenly nothing feels quite right. Why does the sunshine feel like night? I'm only pretending I'm alright without you.
Now what's a macaroni without the cheese? Or peas in a pod without the peas? That's the way I feel when there's no me without you.
His chill. Don't know what you've done, but I'm all a thrill. From now on, lady, I insist. For me, no other girls exist.
In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking. Now heaven knows anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, and most guys today, the women prize today, are just silly gigolos. And though I'm not a great romancer, I know that I'm bound to answer when you propose. Anything goes.
It's wonderful, it's marvelous. You should care for
me.
Awful nice, it's paradise, it's what I love to see.
I'm not a great romancer,
my dear, it's four-leaf clover time.
Good's bad today, black.
From now on, my heart's working overtime. It's wonderful.
We've rewound the clock,
it's marvelous.
Left on Plymouth Rock,
that you should care for me.
Thank you.
wonderful.
Doing here?
I'm living here.
Wow, you know, I never pictured you living anywhere. You just exist.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I do live places, and right now it's here. I got a key, I get mail, I wear an apron.
Must go good with your eyes.
I heard Chai was in town, so I thought I'd stop by and say hello. Hello. A pen, a notebook, and a drink. All you need is a social disease, and you're officially a road comic. How long are you in town?
2 frizz-filled weeks.
Good. Well, I'm heading out of town to make some money, but I thought we should grab a drink.
I would love that. You should have seen my set.
Oh, I saw your set.
You did? How was I?
Wow. Just like that? I usually start off with small talk. Hi, how have you been?
Nope. Life's too short. Talk about me. You're staring.
Am I?
Do I have a hair out of place?
I didn't know how to tell you.
You're still staring.
So are you. Come on. What's the matter?
I just can't think of anything funny to say.
Yeah. Me neither. It's kind of nice, isn't it?
Is that your apartment building?
No. This is my hotel.
Your hotel? You're living in a hotel? Who are you, Willy Loman?
Hey, this is a very nice hotel. I've got a pool, they bring me towels, the little soaps are adorable.
But it's not permanent.
I didn't say permanent. I said I got mail.
Oh, I just assumed that when you said you lived in Florida, that meant you had an apartment.
Does it matter?
No. No, it doesn't.
You like a man who has a lease.
Depends on the man, depends on the lease.
Well, I'm paid up through Friday. All right, this is me.
I had a good time.
That was the intent.
So what did you think of my act?
I thought it was sensational.
I reflect on my reflection, and I ask myself the question. What's the right direction to go? I don't know. Am I a man? Or am I a Muppet?
Am I a Muppet?
If I'm a Muppet, then I'm a very manly Muppet.
Very manly Muppet.
Am I a Muppet? Understand who
Baby. Hello.
Looks just like me.
Yes, it does. Smaller.
Well, yes. Hello, baby. Hello.
Daddy's
little baked potato.
Don't call the child a baked potato.
It's a term of affection.
It isn't. It's a food. No one wants to be called a baked potato.
Well, it doesn't even speak English.
The various books say you should presume your child can understand you. We don't want it to have problems in kindergarten or marriage because you call it a baked potato.
Oh, honey, it seems to me that you're losing your sense of humor.
No, I just don't want to make the child insane. That's all. Bringing up a child is a delicate thing.
All right, then. Well, you're not a baked potato, sweet pea. And you're not a sweet pea either. You're a baby, 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 baby.
I want a divorce.
What?
You heard me. I want a divorce.
But you read the statistics on children with broken homes. Do you want to do that to our child?
Oh, I don't feel ready for marriage. I didn't when we got married. I should have said no.
What are you talking about?
Can't you speak English? God, I'm married to an idiot. Your father is an idiot. Oh, God. It's crying. What should we do?
Sing to it.
Oh, yeah.
There's no business like show business like
no, 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 a lullaby, sweetheart.
I don't know any lullabies.
Hush, little baby, don't you cry. Mom's gonna give you a big black eye.
Good heavens, those aren't the lyrics.
I know those aren't the lyrics. I can't remember the right ones.
Oh, God, you're gonna teach baby all the wrong lyrics to everything. It's gonna have problems with its peer group.
Maybe we should hold it to stop it from crying.
We might drop it. I had a cocktail for breakfast. I'm not steady.
Wait, why did you have a cocktail for breakfast?
Oh, you are always picking on me. I'm sorry I married you. I'm sorry I gave birth to baby. I wish we were back at the Spence school.
But we love the baby.
Oh, how can we love the baby? It won't stop that noise. Shut up, baby. Just stop.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Please make it stop.
Just wanna be
crying all the time.
Let it
down. You ain't nothing but a
ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine. Never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine.
I just wanna be your teddy bear.
What are you making a checklist for a night of partying?
Of course I am. Killer outfit, safety tutorial, check, check. Mm-hmm. Get address, secure safe transportation, you find Ryan, flirt for 15, 20 minutes, bring her somewhere more quiet, ride her like a pony, I prove I'm fun, home by one!
Are you gonna hook up with anybody?
No. Yeah. No way. Mm. High school boys are just horny, pimply distractions. Men don't even become viable till they're like 28, and then they don't peak till they're like 40. I'm holding out for an econ TA next year.
If Ryan wants to go further than just making out, I have no idea what to do. Down there.
Of course you do. You have the same parts she does. Just take what you do to yourself and turn it upside down.
I don't really do anything.
Guys talk about this stuff all the time. It's honestly offensive. We don't. It's misogynistic of us.
What if I don't use my hands?
You can make yourself come using only your mind? That's the one thing my mind can't do.
No, I use like other things.
A book. That's very Freudian, but I worry about paper cuts.
No, like something soft. Can we please just stop talking about this?
The alligator.
No.
The dog.
No, my grandma gave that to me right before
the
she died.
That's all I can use!
The panda. Okay, whatever.
What happened to his eye?
That fell off way before anything happened between us.
Does he talk dirty to you?
Oh my god.
Tell you that he's in danger. You sneaky bitch! I can't believe you didn't tell me you've been mounting the old fuzzy panda every night. Honestly, it's kind of exhilarating. I thought we knew everything about each other. It's probably healthy for a relationship to have a secret, and now we have one. Do I have any? I once tried to masturbate using an electric toothbrush, but I just got a terrible UTI.
I wish that had been a secret, but you have mentioned it many, many times.
You and I shall live and die underneath the Colorado sky. Very soon we'll have our June underneath the Colorado moon. Though I must leave, you must believe, my lonely heart will grieve till then. I must be stern.
And for your lonely sake, my heart will ache and quake and break if you do not return. My heart will yearn and burn, so please return.
My heart can only wait for you.
My heart is waiting for you too.
And with this promise to be true, t'will see me through.
T'will see me through.
And yet I'll count the lonely hours.
I'll count the lonely hours.
Till we can be as one.
Till we can be as one.
As one.
As one.
Then. And I shall live and die underneath the Colorado sky.
Till then I'll try.
Till then I'll try
to say goodbye.
To say goodbye.
Goodbye, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, goodbye.
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 Thank you.
How are you?
It's good to see you.
Are you pregnant?
What? I've been trying to have a baby, yes, but it's probably not even going to stick.
Yeah, I think it's stuck.
Okay, I don't know what that tone was, but apparently you noticed my boobs have gotten bigger.
Yeah, of course I noticed your boobs getting bigger. I put that on my vision board, okay? Thought that was because of me.
Who does that?
I do. People like me, visionaries.
Am I getting fat?
No. You are not getting fat. You are beautiful. You have always been beautiful, and you are carrying this so well.
Do you think?
Yeah. Is this why you've been avoiding me lately? Mm-hmm. Oh my God, I think I'm gonna be a dad.
What?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, we're gonna have a kid.
No,
we're gonna be
not.
A dad.
Like, you're not gonna be a dad.
I'm gonna be a dad.
It's not.
Is that not mine?
I'm just pregnant.
What do you mean you're just pregnant? That's crazy. How is that possible?
What?
I said you're being crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You've lied to me the entire time we've been together about mm-hmm. you being pregnant, and now you're upset with me because I believed it? That's what a crazy person does.
Oh, that's three times. Say it again.
It just seems crazy to me.
I'm going to tell you something. Usually it's not a good idea to call a pregnant woman crazy. You know what I mean?
Who's the father?
I don't know. I don't know.
How do you not know?
Stop yelling at me.
How do you not know something like that? Did you not catch his name?
Well, I did IVF with a sperm donor. Oh my God, okay?
Babe, if we're going to make this thing work, like, this is the kind of thing I need to know about.
What are you going to do? Stay at home and take care of a baby?
Did I just win the lottery? Yes, I want to stay at home and take care of a baby. When I was 8 years old, my Halloween costume was a stay-at-home dad. You're saying I never have to go to work? I get to hang out with a baby all day?
Just stop saying the word baby.
Baby, baby, baby. Baby.
Oh!
Because babies are awesome.
If I could choose someone to do this with, it would be you.
You can choose.
I'm not the only one I'm choosing for anymore.
Yeah, well, for the record, this is not me leaving. This is you pushing me away.
Drop that long face, come on, have your fling. Why keep nursing the blues? If you want this whole world on a string, put on your dancing shoes, stop wasting time. Put on your dancing shoes, watch your spirits climb.
Shall we dance or keep on moping? Shall we dance and walk on air? Shall we give in to despair?
Or shall we dance but never a care?
Cares if the sky cares to fall in the sea? Who cares what banks fail in Yonkers?
Long as you've got a kiss that conquers.
Why should I care? Life is one long jubilee.
So long as I care for you, and you care for me.
Have one more song to sing. I'm not ready to end my set. Think of how much more joy I could bring.
But curtains fall, lights descend.
There's curtain call, the story ends.
But this time tomorrow I'll be back on my feet.
I'll face the day, come what may. I'll see it through.
This time tomorrow,
oh, won't it be sweet?
Sing one more song.
Just a moment before we go, I still have one more thing to say.
I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for giving me somewhere to play.
Before the curtains fall and the lights descend,
before the curtain call and our story ends.
This time tomorrow I'll be back on my feet. I'll face the day come what may, I'll see it through.
This time tomorrow, oh, won't it be sweet to sing one more song.
So it seems that little girls had fantasies.
She was walking around with a loaded shotgun, ready to fire me a hot one.
I could bitch, cause I'm better than you. It's the way that I move, the things that I do.
And when you see someone's hurt and in need of a hand, don't forget me.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
I just wanna be without a teddy bear.
Heart, keep racing, let's make mistakes.
Let us say so what and make worse what was already pretty bad.
Shall we dance or keep on moping? Shall we dance and walk on air?
It's wonderful,
it's marvelous
that you should care for.
You and I shall live and die underneath the Colorado sky.
Just take the second star on the right, straight ahead to the morning light.
Love me not, counting petals on the floor.
I guess I miss you.
Am I a man or am I a Muppet? Am I a Muppet?